Hi and welcome to this additional video of the Ableton Live Tools for SPAT Revolution series. Now comes the time to think about how to render what we made inside Live and SPAT Revolution. There are a few strategies about this. But the absolute main thing we cannot avoid is that we need to real-time render what we made. Let's have a use case to demonstrate how to print a mix. So this is a mostly done session I made. We have two renders to do. The binaural one, which is composed of two rooms. The second is my Atmos room. As binaural is a 2-channel render and Atmos a 12 one, we have a total of 14 channels to render at the same time. You can either have a 14 channel or more virtual device to route all of this, or you can create an aggregate device to combine multiple devices into one. I do have a 16 channel virtual audio driver, which should be enough, but for the sake of this demonstration, I will still make an aggregate device. And plus, I like to have the different renders completely separated, in case I need to duplicate the routing to send them to actual physical output while I'm rendering.
First, we need to quit Live and SPAT. Now, let's create this aggregate device by opening the Audio MIDI setup panel of macOS. At the bottom of the window, we will click the plus and select the aggregate device.
Now we can select which device we want to be part of this aggregate.
I am going to choose Black Hole 2 channel first for the binaural render and the Black Hole 16 channel for the Atmos one. Once this is done, you can reopen both Live and SPAT and the sessions. We will now change the input of Live for the aggregate device and then activate the channel we want to use. Then select the same aggregate device as the output in SPAT. Go back to the setup page of SPAT, click the output block, and verify that they are correctly routed. As I combined a 2-channel and a 16-channel device together, the first and the second channel are for my binaural block, so here nothing changed, and I am going to set the output channels of the Atmos block from 3 to 14.
The only thing left to do is to create the track inside Live that will receive the audio, route them to the corresponding channels, and last, arm the recording. We can start the rendering by pressing record. Be sure to check out the other videos of the series if you haven't, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell to not miss the next videos. And I will see you in the next one.